NFL Basketball is sponsored by Pepsi-Cola General Bottlers, makers of Pepsi, Mountain Dew, and today's All Sport, the isotonic drink of the Louisville Cardinals. By Great Financial Federal, your key to financial security. By Alliant Health System, where wonders never cease. And by McDonald's. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
We are back in Tampa, Florida, where, by the way, it was 85 degrees here this afternoon. We're inside, though. The building is getting warm as fireworks go off in one end of the arena as they're getting ready to introduce the players of South Florida here. We will tell you that the first half of tonight's game is brought to you by Alliant Health System, where wonders never cease. The series between the Bulls and the Cardinals does not date back all that far, but Louisville commands the series. They've won 5 out of 6 games. You can see 5-1 Louisville in the last meeting in January, which was played in Freedom Hall, 80-56. Louisville won that very handily. The Sun Dome here in Tampa holds about 10,400. They're not at capacity, but very close to it, as the Florida, South Florida Bulls, big underdogs tonight to the 7th and 9th ranked Louisville Cardinals. And you can see under the dome here, we mentioned earlier, Tony Branch, this South Florida team has been unbeaten here over their last 10 home games.
That home court advantage, that home court adrenaline, two really fun matchups to watch. Dwan Wheat and Chucky Atkins, and also inside Salters and Rozier.
As you can see, Louisville holds a commanding lead in the conference. They're 7-1 in conference play, 18-2 overall. Then you got a group at 500, VCU, UNC Charlotte, and Southern Miss, Tulane. Then you find South Florida 2-4 in the Metro Conference, Virginia Tech at 2-5. And of all those teams, you know, South Florida is the only one on the season under 500. As you look at Denny Crum, a last-minute talk with his team before he sends them out.
I'm sure he's telling them, Dave, let's go out and let's play like a championship team, a tournament team. Does not matter what their record is. That's why upsets occur. Let's play to our ability tonight.
Clifford Rozier, number 44, a native of Bradenton, Florida. Of course, just a few miles away from where we sit tonight in Tampa.
And his family's here tonight. And also, you know, Clifford beat out Jesse Salters for Mr. Basketball Award here in the state of Florida as seniors in high school. And I know they both always look forward to that matchup.
Well, they're about ready to match up again. As you look at Jesse Salters still in the pregame huddle in the late break, and South Florida will come out now to face off against Louisville. And Jesse Salters, who is a junior from here in Tampa, had that severely sprained ankle on Monday in a losing effort against Central Florida. Somehow they've gotten him ready to play tonight.
What a fighter. You know, he's also come back off of a knee surgery, and he is just a competitor and a fighter. But if he is not able to go look for Donzel Rush, the 6'9 sophomore, to come off the bench and try to contain Clifford Rozier.
Well, Louisville, Greg Miner has it to open up play. The Cardinals 18-2, off to the best start since the 79-80 national championship team went 25-2. Jason Osborne way outside the three-point arc. They give it to Rozier, a stab at it. They try to take it away. It goes out of bounds. South Florida will get it.
And South Florida is playing man-to-man against Louisville, and they're giving up 2-3 inches at forward positions.
There are two ways to go against it. Either you sag back on Rozier, but if you do that, Louisville's got the outside shot.
And that's one of their problems, but they're going to see their strategy going in tonight was let Rozier get his 30 and let's contain the other four. Let's see how that works.
First shot is no good, and Rozier has the opening rebound off to Jason Osborne. Osborne, one of the two freshmen that start for Louisville. This is the other one, Dewan Wheat. They're going to go right back inside. Rozier with the move and kicks it out. Morton, a three. Hit the iron, came out, rebound South Florida, taken by Jesse Salters.
Great pass out by Rozier when he saw the open man on the perimeter. And then we see, as we'll see this time down the court, last year's Metro freshman runner-up and a great candidate for this year's Metro Conference Freshman Player of the Year, Dwan Wheat and Chucky Atkins right now.
Chucky Atkins, number 12 in the white uniform, 32, of course, Dwan Wheat. This is Rozier with it. Top of the key, takes a dribble and takes a jump shot, no good. South Florida will run it right back down court. Bulls average about 65 points a game. Louisville's averaging 85, and that is the highest scoring team so far that Denny Crum has coached at Louisville.
Louisville in their man-to-man, their classic switching man-to-man.
Looking for our first point in this game. Chucky Atkins. Three-pointer for Atkins, and South Florida has hit the basket first. Jason Osborne for two. He's off, and so far, Louisville has been unable to get a shot to drop.
So far, it looks like Jesse Salters is able to move a little bit laterally and keep Rozier off the basket.
The Bulls with a 3-0 lead and the basketball. Jesse Salters, one-on-one, takes the shot over Rozier. No good, and Osborne with a rebound. Osborne will lead the Cardinals on the break as they go to Miner. Jump shot is up, and he got it, banked it in.
He's still in that zone, and that's nice for Louisville fans to see.
Four games, he's hit 75% of his shots from the field. 30-some-odd field goals out of 50-some attempts.
Everybody wishes to have that kind of streak during the season.
Miner matched up now against Summers, number four, a junior guard. Summers drives the baseline out to Salters. That's an air ball, and the rebound, Rozier to DeJuan Haight. Walks it up for the jam by Morton.
Dwayne Morton, he can get down the floor, and he can get up in the air.
And the assist to DeJuan Haight.
This Louisville team is awfully quick everywhere, at every position, and that's why they're hard to guard.
And they lead 4-3. Chucky Atkins' three-pointer, the only basket made by the Bulls.
Last shot by Salters. You can tell that he's not full strength on that ankle. He's favoring it a little bit.
Robinson, follow. Boy, it's rough under the boards, Tony. They're not calling much.
That's going to be the Bulls' problem tonight. They're intimidated inside a little bit with Rozier and Osborne in there.
The charge is going to go against DeJuan Haight. That'll be his first. Let's look again at that alley-oop that DeJuan Haight lofted up there so nicely for Morton.
The great thing about this play is the pass. It's very difficult pass right on time, right on the target from half court.
Perfectly executed. Louisville 4-3 over South Florida. Atkins with it. The Bulls not a great shooting team. 42% for the year from the field.
And they haven't established anything inside yet.
31% three-pointers. Here's Miner's going to get it up to Osborne all alone.
The Wizard! Louisville's going to see a lot of that over the next 3 years.
And so Louisville now 6-3. Both teams have committed, or each team has committed, two turnovers in the early part of this game. Louisville's gotten 6 points in the paint.
And then USF, no points in the paint yet. We've played about 5 minutes. They've got to be able to not only get it in there, but complete the play. That's going to be their problem tonight.
Get it inside. Robinson off the mark. Rozier knocks it out of bounds, they say.
You see the great execution on the pass inside to Robinson, but they couldn't complete the play. The Louisville athletes inside.
Timeout on the court. Rozier didn't like the call. The ball goes over to South Florida. We'll be back after this break.
Idea behind the new Mercury Cougar. Its interior is designed to wrap around you, to put everything within easy reach.
Including this, a great low price. And now Mercury Cougar's all-new wraparound interior offers standard dual airbag protection and more standard features than before.
So wrap yourself in a new Mercury Cougar. You'll find the attraction is purely physical. At your Lincoln Mercury dealer now.
At some fast food restaurants, the burgers hang around in the red light district until you drop in. Not at Rally's. Every Rally burger is made to order fresh for you in less than a minute.
Now you can buy a freshly made Rally burger for just 79 cents. No wonder Rally's has the lowest average guest check of any major hamburger chain.
The 7-Up Shootout. That's coming up from Orlando. And you could make plans to get there through Travel Specialist 426-3333. It's in Orlando. And that's going to be U of L taking on Temple February the 20th. And the baseball team, U of L baseball team down there as well, playing over the weekend starting on Friday against Northwestern. They got three games. I want to take that in. 5 seconds, four on the shot clock. Atkins lifts it, no good. The Bulls of South Florida try to save it. Inbounds, they do. Jackson on the floor. And it's picked up finally by Rozier. Louisville leads it 6-3. There's the pass to the Wheat. Dewan Wheat gets the feed from Rozier. Just flip-flop thing.
Isn't that supposed to happen the other way around? The 6'9 Rozier dribbles it the length of the floor. In the middle, running the point like a point guard. Dishes.
He looked the other way, flipped the pass over to Wheat.
He's quite talented, has a lot of skills.
This telecast is authorized under rights granted by the University of Louisville Athletic Association to WDRB-TV Fox 41. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other uses of audio or video portions of this telecast without the written express permission of WDRB-TV Fox 41 or the University of Louisville Athletic Association is prohibited. Back to play.
We've got Robert Polk in the game now, and he's shooting the ball well from the perimeter.
Speaking of shooting well, Louisville hitting 57% early from the field, and South Florida 1 out of 8. Underneath, Salters had a hand put on it. Rozier up to Jason Osborne. He'll go 1-on-1 and flip it outside to Dewan Wheat. They go inside, Rozier. As he went up against Salters, the foul is going to be on 23, Jesse Salters.
Robert Polk scored 30 this year. We see the pass inside to Rozier. Great hands. You see him go get that with one hand. It's going to be tough for them to stop him inside without help. But Robert Polk, a 7 for 10 from the three-point line against VCU this year, and scored 30, so he can shoot the ball. That's 21 for the Bulls. And Rozier going to get fouled. He's going to have to put it up there with a soft touch on target. Great shot. Soft touch on target. It went down.
He got 1 out of 2, and he's a 57% shooter from the free throw line. A couple of substitutes come in for South Florida. Donzel Rush, the man you spoke about at 6'9", is in, a sophomore out of Miami.
They need Donzel to play tough tonight because he's the only guy really can match up with Rozier and the same size as Rozier inside.
We're just moving towards a 14-minute mark here at the Sun Dome in Tampa. Polk and Wheat. Polk beats off on the side. Now inside Robinson. He's double and triple team. Out of bounds to South Florida.
Great job by South Florida. Great passing. Great setup inside to Robinson. Rozier, Osborne, Miner, Morton. It's tough to get shots off in there for them.
That was the first point of the game for Rozier when he hit that free throw. Now all five starters have scored for Louisville. The miss and the rebound picked up by Morton. Louisville up by 6 at 9-3. Rozier looking for his first field goal, pivoting around. They're going to get him on a hold inside.
You know, Clifford shows such great poise inside. He had a double team on him. He doesn't panic. Holds the ball tight. Looks over the floor, gets rid of it, or goes to the hoop. Good job.
Foul goes on Donzel Rush, number 32. A break in the action. We'll be back. Stay with us.
Wetlands are places that hold water for periods of time. They contain plants adapted to wet conditions and soils that filter water. Once thought of as disease-ridden, today wetlands are recognized as productive areas because they improve water quality, control floodwaters and erosion, and protect wildlife. In Kentucky, 75% of our wetlands have been destroyed. Protecting wetlands is part of having an Earth attitude. Brought to you by Fox 41 and Romanhaus, Kentucky.
Discovery is a powerful learning tool, and it can be a lot of fun. That's why Romanhaus, Kentucky sponsored Mr. Wizard's World of Discovery for area school children at the Museum of History and Science. We hope programs like this and other visits to the museum get these kids excited about learning and discovering the world around them. After all, it's kids like these who grow up to work for companies like ours.
Enjoy tonight's game, and don't forget to order your Papa John's Cardinal Special, a large double pepperoni pizza for only $7.88. That's the Cardinal Special. All right, now the Cardinals lead the Bulls of South Florida here in Tampa 9-3. All five starters have scored. It's very balanced, and it will be the inbounds from Osborne. Now Greg Miner with it. Go inside to Rozier. He makes a move, goes up with a shot. It won't fall, but he got the foul.
He has just instinctive moves inside. He's hard for anybody to time. You just can't let a great player like that, an All-American, catch the ball that low. But, you know, Pascal inside from Miner into Rozier. Okay, looked like he traveled. They missed it. He's hitting his free throws better. It looks like he has a better touch now, and he's making sure it's on target. That's really going to help Louisville's team out this year.
Two out of four tonight for Rozier, and those are all
great steal by Martin. Couldn't get it to go down.
Louisville hustling all over the court, especially Martin defensively. Got him on a foul there, going over trying desperately to get the ball.
Pascal's got a dilemma here. He doesn't want to really get in a running game with Louisville, but he's having trouble scoring, even when they get the ball inside for good shots. So maybe he has to adjust and run so that they get some open court shots and some layups.
Two team fouls on Louisville, three on South Florida. 13:20 to go in a ball game in the first half. Louisville leads it right now 10-3. Waters only hit, one out of 11 from the floor. They got the foul coming up. I believe it's going to be on 44. It is, Rozier. That's number one on Clifford.
And you've got to give Louisville's defense credit. They're staying in great position. They're intimidating shots. And when they do break down, the great shot blockers come to life inside.
That's Polk with it, number 21, against DeJuan Wheat outside.
And you know what? University of South Florida has some pretty good athletes on the floor.
Polk, a good shooter. He can't get it to fall. But Rush, Donzel Rush, goes over and recovers the rebound. Rush shut off, and that is taken away from him. Great defense by Louisville.
The Bulls have some pretty good athletes, but they're still being intimidated by Louisville's play.
Osborne's three was off the mark.
Juncture, it's a seven-point game. Can't get
Hyatt down on the floor. Traveling is called on Vincent Hyatt. He's a senior out of Moorhaven, Florida. Bobby Pascal's team with only 3 points, and we played over 7.5 minutes of the ball game.
Right, that's a good call. Can't get off the floor.
They only hit one shot, Tony. That was the three by Atkins early.
And they've gotten some good shots. They couldn't complete them because of Louisville's defense inside.
So Louisville with Wheat driving down and kicking it out to Miner, but we got a foul. And John Clarkety says it's on DeJuan Wheat. And that's two on DeJuan Wheat.
Credit the Bulls' defense. Get in front of him if he leaves his feet. Get the charge. But DeJuan Wheat, great offensive creativity, draws three guys to him and dishes to the open man. Just couldn't stop in time. That's what he helps Louisville to get those open shots.
And Denny Crum pulls DeJuan Wheat with two fouls out at the 12-13 mark, and Chick Rogers, number four, is into the game.
So we have the two premier guards out resting now, Atkins and Wheat. Some really good young players in the league, Rush, Wheat.
Martin again with a steal and the fast break, and it's no good. Morton is still sitting down under the on that baseline as the action comes this way to Donzel Rush.
He thought Rozier was there. That's the only reason he missed that.
Oh, you talk about intimidation.
And there was nobody there, Dave.
The shadow. Rush again. He looks terrified. Polk will take it from the baseline. Got it. 10-5. Loyola's lead is 5 points, 11:25 and a half.
And South Florida's still in good shape. It's a 5-point game, and they haven't been able to score yet.
Rozier moves against Donzel Rush, puts it up and got it.
Help didn't come that time. They're hoping that Rush can stay between him and the basket and make it a little tougher for him to score.
Rush, I think you hit it on the head, is completely intimidated by Rozier. Rozier's going to come out for defense on him at the top of the key and go for it.
And you do.
You can see the points in the paint statistic, Tony, something you wanted to keep an eye on tonight.
Right.
Inside game.
And South Florida's gotten it inside but hasn't been able to complete the play. Louisville's defense is awfully tough.
Polk will put another one up and got it as the shot clock ran down. So 4 points by Polk, and it's 12-7.
I can see why he scored 30 on VCU. He has a pretty jump shot, and it gets off the floor.
He is a senior. And now Louisville, as the clock moves to the 10-minute mark of the first half. Dwayne Morton makes a quick move along the side, and they got the foul on 31 Robinson.
And this
That's
is
his first.
This is one thing I think Louisville can work on. Is they had South Florida on the verge of blowing open into a double-figure lead. Now it's a 5-point game. They could not sustain it, and that's what I meant early, sustain that pressure D.
Kaiser in relief of Morton. So Kaiser number three and Tick Rogers number four off of the Louisville bench. Rozier, turn around, puts it up, short. Kaiser almost got it to go, and now it's Osborne with it. Whips the pass to Rozier. Robinson with a rebound for South Florida. So the interception by Osborne. Put it in.
You know, Osborne has quick hands and such long arms. He's going to have a lot of steals in his career. Great anticipation to go with that.
Certainly is. He's got four of Louisville's 14 points. Ducky Atkins back in.
That's a nice jump hook by Jerome Robinson. He shot that one down on the basket. He's only 6'7".
That's 14-9. Osborne along the baseline. Kaiser, Rozier put it in.
Nice job by Kaiser. It's nice to see him in here at this stage of the game.
6 points for Rozier. Clifford Rozier, 16-9, Louisville by seven. 9:08 to go in the first half. Tick Rogers knocks it away.
What a great defensive play.
He's out of bounds.
What a great defensive play by Tick.
30 steals coming into the game for Tick Rogers as Denny Crum watches from the sideline and teams up.
Let me tell you something about Tick's place. Knock the ball away and beat a guy to it. You know, again, South Florida inside can't get it. He beat the guy to it. The guy was in front of him, but he beat him to the ball. What great hustle.
Back to action. Louisville by seven at 16-9. 8:52 to go. Shots up and in by Robinson.
He
so Robinson's
good on
got
that.
Four.
Looks like we see a 2-3 zone from the Bulls now.
Kaiser will give it to Osborne. Three-pointer by Miner off the mark. Walters with a rebound.
Look at how Chucky Atkins runs the ball up the floor and gets in the lane with it. He put so much pressure on the defense by doing that, running it up, getting in the lane with it. Probably should have converted that one.
Kaiser for three. Lamarck.
If I had to had one criticism of Kaiser, he takes too long to get his shot off. He's got to catch it, be ready to shoot, get that thing off quicker. Jarvis Jackson from the left corner. And they're feeling it, Dave.
16-13, all of a sudden, in the last couple of minutes, South Florida's found the shooting touch. Move inside 8 minutes.
Nice change of pace. Nice change of pace for Pascal going to the 2-3 zone. It slows the game down, and if Louisville takes perimeter shots and misses, they're able to run. They won't run off of that one, though.
I was going to say, they can't stop that. 8 points for Rozier. 18-13, Louisville's lead is at five.
kids that want to learn how to play defense, watch Tick Rogers play Chucky Atkins on defense over there in that left corner, now running the baseline.
Jump shot from the corner, off the mark, comes to Kaiser, over to Miner. Louisville by five with a ball. Jason Osborne.
Oh, he was fouled.
They didn't call it. That's three field goals and 6 points for Osborne, 20-13.
I think Jason has the ability to score a lot more points, but I think he's blended in very well chemistry-wise with this team, and it makes him a better team.
Louisville in South Florida from the Sun Dome in Tampa, and it's been Louisville on top throughout this first half. Polk, outside three, short. He comes up with it over to Atkins, actually, in action. Atkins against Kaiser. In the paint. And the foul.
And that's what South Florida is going to have to do. Start completing those plays inside. Not be intimidated once they get it in by Osborne and Rozier and Miner and Morton. Easier said than done. Great pass in by Atkins. There, Jerome Robinson took it up strong, and he's a great athlete. He can get up in the air on his shot.
And the foul is on Greg Miner, number one. 14 fouls on each team now.
We thought there was a timeout, but apparently no timeout, Dave. But if you want to be a great point guard, I think one of the things...
Monday, got up, got a shower, drove to work, played cash five.
Into that 80 championship team.
You see the shooting percentage? It's kind of closed. That gap is closed from just 9%. As South Florida hit only one of their first 11. And now over 30%. Morton back into the lineup, drives and misses.
Watch Chucky run the ball up the floor and put pressure on the defense.
Atkins quickly up court. Jump shot outside, hits the front of the iron. Louisville on a break quickly the other way. DeJuan Wheat will take the shot with Morton underneath, and he hit it. It's a two. That's four for DeJuan Wheat. Louisville's lead, 22-16.
This is worth the price of admission. Just watching Chucky Atkins and DeJuan Wheat out here going at it.
Ryan Kaiser remains in the game as two more changes are coming up. Summers, good from the shot on the side.
Atkins goes around Wheat, creates, and finds the man in the corner.
Lotus lead trimmed to four, 22-18, 5:25 here in the first half of the Sun Dome. Wheat for three, and it's off the mark. Kaiser tips, Rozier, and now Morton. Rozier's got it. No basket, offensive foul on Clifford Rozier. That'll be two on number 44, who shakes his head.
USF is doing a great job with Rozier. Catches the ball. It's just staying between him and the basket. If he jumps into him, they're going to foul. This is a good call. If you jump, the defense has a right to their vertical plane. Rozier jumped back into the defense.
He's out now. Denny Crum gives him a rest. And Matt Simons, number 40, is in for Rozier with his second foul. And he scored 8 points. 22-18. South Florida can get within 2 or 3 points on this trip down court. Shot clock is inside 14 seconds. Game clock's at 4.5 here, first half. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Summers lofts it for Jesse Soldiers. No good.
And he normally doesn't miss shots like that.
Now Wade whips it over to Morton. Morton draws the foul.
Jesse Salters normally does not miss shots like that. I really think he's worried about coming down on that severely sprained ankle of his, and it's bothering him when he's in the air.
That's the first on Greg Summers. Inbounds pass, Osborne to Miner. Little 22-18 lead.
Osborne, look at that move. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness, you can say it. That's four field goals, 8 points for Jason Osborne. He ties Rozier for scoring honors with that basket. Out of bounds, off Louisville, South Florida will keep it.
That's a 6'9 forward, putting the ball on the floor with his right hand, turning down the lane, and then using his left hand on the layup.
Great move by Osborne. 24-18, Louisville by 6 at the Sun Dome with a timeout. South Florida with a two rebound edge over U of L and steals. So far, the Bulls have yet to come up with one. Tenacious defense by the Cardinals. It's a 6-point game. There's another turnover there. South Florida throws it out.
They can't do that, and they got to cut off the steals, which means they got to do better passing to stay in this ball game. And they're in pretty good shape right now.
24-18, Louisville by 6, 3:52 to go in the first half. Jason Osborne has 8, Rozier on the bench with 8. Matt Simon still in the pivot. The freshman out of Shelbyville. Here is Osborne. He feeds nicely, and it is blocked from behind, but they're going to call a foul on South Florida as Jackson went up and, or Robinson rather, that'll be 2 on Robinson.
Nice pass inside, great hands. You see Jerome Robinson can get up with Dwayne Morton in there, so we see the kind of talent that's on the floor tonight.
Dwayne Morton will be at the free throw stripe.
One thing Dwayne can improve on also is his free throw shooting. He's only shooting about
67%.
And he's a much better shooter than that. Dwayne Morton should be shooting 80% or better from the free throw line.
3 points, and he'll be shooting for his 4th point with the second free throw.
And that might be a little bit due to the injury he had earlier in the year with his wrist.
Broke the wrist in early October. He's 2 for 2. 26-18. Cardinals by 8. South Florida makes a substitution, bringing 4 Greg Summers back in.
I think the pace of this game is in South Florida's favor.
Louisville pressing. And we're going to trap in the backcourt. Osborne and Wheat. Ducky Atkins in trouble. Gets away to Summers in the paint. They're going to wave it off. And they're calling a foul on Matt Simons. That's number 1 on Simons.
The foul on Matt Simons is his first in the league.
I think Matt was determined not to let Summers get the shot off, but probably could have gotten back and made it a tough shot without the foul.
As a team, South Florida at the free throw stripe as they go to the 1-1 with Summers shooting 67%. Louisville as a team is 64%. They get their own rebound and put it in. That's Jesse Salters. That's his first basket of the game. That's something you never want to see happen.
Exactly. A lack of blocking out there on the free throw line. The shot by Summers.
Simons just lost the handle on it and tipped it over, and Salters put it in.
I believe Salters came from Jason Osborne's side of the lane on that shot.
Now let's see. Salters, 67% at the line. Makes out a 3-point play. Now we got a 5-point game. 26-21 Louisville. Time of the game, as you see, 3:19 in the first half. Rozier goes to the scorer's table and waits to report back in. Well, Simons has kind of done his job and given Rozier a break.
Exactly. They need him just not to turn it over, to bang and rebound, and play tough defense when he's in there.
Simons with the feed to Miner.
Very nice feed by Matt.
Didn't get the ball to call. Now South Florida can cut into the 5-point Louisville lead. Summers.
Oh, my. What a great rebound and offensive play.
South Florida is hanging in this game, 26-23.
You know what? They have confidence now that they can play with Louisville.
Simons in the paint. He looks like he's hurt himself. They've called Simons on the offensive charge.
I think Matt just needs to fit in with the other great scorers on the floor and not really look so much offensively at this stage in his career with Rozier on the bench. Hopefully he's not hurt too poorly, but you can't fault him for playing aggressively. Inside, not a bad move because his man went for the steal, but probably he should have pulled up for the short jumper.
Now this is the only backup you've got for Rozier to give Clifford some relief.
And this is something that could happen to Louisville once they make it to the NCAA tournament. Rozier gets two early fouls. They really need somebody to come off the bench and fill that role as a big man for them. He's limping off.
Like perhaps an ankle sprain, or we'll get word when we can here shortly as to the injury. Or they could tie this game. They could make it right even at halftime.
Or just to go in with it, a three-point game.
Chucky Atkins fires an air ball, but every time they've got the chance, they don't come up with the play.
I'm surprised they haven't gone inside the last two times down.
Jason Osmond with a fake. Rozier puts it up one-handed and scores. 10 points, Clifford Rozier. 28-23, Louisville by five, a minute seven. This has not been a great exhibition of three-point shooting. Louisville's 0 for 5. South Florida's 1 out of 3. Inside the minute mark of the first half. Shot clock's at 7. Outside Jackson. Got it. 2-point shot by Jarvis Jackson. 28 to 25.
South Florida didn't go after Rozier, having to come back in the game with two fouls in that last 2 minutes.
Louisville works it down for the last shot of the half. The shot clock is turned off. That is the game clock counting down. Chucky Atkins fouling DeJuan Wheat. That'll be number one on my score sheet. Let's take a look down at our LDDS long distance scoreboard, brought to you by LDDS, supporting Cardinal Athletics with a Cardinal calling card. UNCC leading Southern Miss big time in the first half. BC over Virginia Tech in another Metro Conference game tonight.
Scored four. For the South Florida Bulls, Robinson with 7, Jackson and Polk each with 4. Salters, by the way, has 3, and Chucky Atkins 3 on hitting 1 3-pointer. And those are your scoring leaders. And your halftime score as we get ready for second half play, 28 to 25. And yes, scatter among the Go Bulls, there is a couple of Card fans. And we get ready to go to the second half of play. And tonight's second half is being brought to you by McDonald's. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today. And we will point out the 28 points matches Louisville's lowest this season for the first half, matching the 28 they scored in their opening game against Kentucky.
Well, Louisville can't be pleased with their first half performance in only a three-point game. Let's see how they play the second half.
Can South Florida get within one or tie it here? Chucky Atkins along the baseline out to Robinson.
Whoa.
And they're within one.
Atkins beat Wheat along the baseline and created that open score.
So South Florida has closed it to a one-point game. Rozier against Salter, spinning, up and in. 12 points, Rozier. Louisville back up by 4-5. Louisville maintains a three-point lead. Atkins of South Florida almost dribbled it off his leg. Jump shot. Three-pointer put up by number 4 Summers, his 4th point.
That's what they've been lacking, is that shooting from the off guard all year. That one goes down.
Louisville 30 to 29 lead.
Salters is just going to stay between Rozier and the basket. He gets around him that time, but they're doing a pretty good job of staying between Rozier and the basket, not giving up layups and dunks.
And now South Florida with a chance to take the lead. Wheat knocks it away, and they're going to signal a foul on DeJuan Wheat. That'll be number 3 on number 32.
Chucky Atkins. He
now
pushes it all the way into the lane.
You got Wheat with 3, Rozier with 2, and no points scored yet by the Louisville bench. By the way, Matt Simons has bruised a muscle. He's going to be okay.
That's a thigh muscle, I believe.
He's got ice on it, but whether we see him in the second half remains to be seen.
Wheat's going to have to be careful because Atkins is going to drive, or he can shoot, but he's very good penetrator.
There's going to be a foul again, this one on Louisville's Dwayne Morton.
That's two on Morton.
Now here's the difference I see between the start of the game and the start of the second half. The University of South Florida, that's Jarvis Jackson, nice penetration. Jerome Robinson, shot fake, gets the foul, but the Bulls have started the second half with a lot more confidence than they did in the first half. And so that confidence is there, and it's going to be a game.
Robinson one for one tonight. Hits 72% of his free throws, averages 11.1 a game. Front of the rim, no good. Now he's got one, another chance. And this would be to tie the game, Tony.
Yes, he could tie it, and had he made both of them, they took the lead, the crowd really would be excited, and it could get interesting.
It's already interesting. Takes his time, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
This time he hits it, and we got a tie game. 30-30, 18:08 to go. Here against Salters, kicks it back. Osborne shot. Morton tips it in. What a beautiful play by Dwayne Morton. 6 points for Morton.
The senior comes through and it's on the line.
Louisville goes up by two at 32-30 with 17:42 to go. Jackson outside. They go to Salters, top of the key. Atkins, Summers. Osborne with a steal. And a pass a little too long from Rozier, and it's picked up by Chucky Atkins. A chancy pass, and it's picked off. Outside shot, rims in and out. Rebound up, it's good by Jesse Salters, number 23, his fifth point of the game. And we're tied again at 32, our second tie. Comes at 17 minutes to go in a game.
And the Sun Dome is now the Noise Dome.
A crowd stamping their feet, getting behind their Bulls. Rozier to Miner, and there is a foul coming from behind. No, they're going to call it on Morton, aren't they?
They call Morton for cooking.
Well, that is the third personal foul on Morton. Two on Rozier and three on Wheat.
You see that? Close call. Could have gone either way.
A victory cheer by the Bulls as Atkins has it in front court and they're in a position to take the lead. We're tied at 32 with 16 and a half to go at the Sun Dome in Tampa. Shot in and out. Rebound is picked up by DeJuan Wheat. Wheat for three. That'll silence the crowd. Seven for Wheat.
Is he a senior?
No, he's a freshman.
Plays like a senior.
16:14 to go, and Louisville leads by three. Wheat has a way of hitting shots when you really need them, and he'll quiet the crowd on the road like he just did.
Clutch player.
Got Rozier out top, and he got a hand on it and a block. Partial block up to Osborne.
Oh, pass ahead. No. Oh, my goodness.
So Wheat. 5 points in the last 30 seconds for DeJuan Wheat, and certainly helped with a tremendous assist.
Oh, my. That was a great
You're
pass.
Out of breath on that one?
Oh, my.
15:30 to go, and it's 37-32. Cardinals have now a five-point lead. After twice being tied, going for the steal, it's going to go to South Florida. Ryan Kaiser reports in. There's a timeout on the court. Louisville 37 and South Florida 32. A lot of time to go. Billy Thompson on the second team. That's quite a collector's edition. Back to action.
Oh, great steal by Osborne.
And he can't save it. Louisville leads us by five at 37-32. If you're just joining us at the Sun Dome in Tampa, Louisville, three-point shooting has not been there yet tonight, but they are hitting 67% in the second half. Bobby Pascal says timeout. Great tournament play. 9 seconds on the clock. Shot clock as they inbounds the play. 8 seconds, 7 seconds. They're not going to get it over the timeline hardly. 4 seconds. Salters dishes it off, and he scores. And it's right at the end of that shot clock. Jackson got the basket. Three-point game.
Louisville trying to put a little more pressure full court now. See what will happen. And USF attacked the press well that last time.
And Jason Osborne guilty of the turnover. Traveling. 37 to 34. And you see the evenness of turnovers. Dead even. 9-9. Still a low number of turnovers. 18 total between the two teams. 37-34 Louisville. Chucky Atkins missed the three, and Miner got the rebound. Miner's been silent tonight. He's had 2 points.
Hold it.
There's a foul on Chucky Atkins. We were looking for Atkins maybe to start driving on DeJuan Wheat, who's got 3 fouls. Flip it the other way, and now 2 on Atkins.
And Atkins is settling for the long-range shot, but you saw that Wheat's quick miss. Atkins, when Wheat drives, Atkins is forced to use his hands to try to contain him, and that's twice that he's picked up a foul trying to contain Wheat on the penetration.
That's the first team foul on South Florida. There are 3 team fouls on Louisville. Ryan Kaiser, they get it into Rozier. Try to double team, and he still scores. 14 points for Rozier. Be trying for another double-double. He's had 16 double rebound, double-figure scoring games this year. 34 over 2 seasons. Chucky Atkins. Gonzel Rush in the game now for the Bulls. For 32. Back to Atkins. 14 seconds. The shot clock winds down to 10. Atkins against Wheat. Kicks it out all alone. Robinson, that's a 2.
Jackson. Yeah,
that's 8 points for Jackson.
If he gets his feet under him over there, he has a pretty nice stroke.
And Louisville's lead at 3. Thirteen and a half minutes left to play at the Sun Dome. Rozier right now 14 points and 6 rebounds. Now they get it to Rozier against Donzel Rush. He goes all around Rush and scores.
My goodness.
I think that's what Donzel must be saying.
What?
Well, can you believe Rozier?
And Pascal's on Rush telling him, don't let him get by you. Just move your body. Don't let him get by you. Make him shoot over you.
5-point advantage, Louisville 41, South Florida 36. They caught South Florida on the foul away from the ball.
I believe they were running Atkins off a pick, and Wheat got caught by, who was that, Hyatt?
Yeah, 25
in the face.
It's number 1 on Hyatt. Look again.
That's look at that. Here. Oh, my goodness.
You think he knew that was going to go in?
Well, he has the eye for the basket. He knows where the basket is around there, and he gets it up there with soft touch.
Cardinals with the ball and a 5-point lead. Brian Kaiser with it. Louisville still looking for his first pass for the bench. Now, Rozier has 8 points in this half, 18 in the game. It's just like they turned him loose.
On a pass from the Wizard.
And it's 43 to 36, Louisville by 7.
Now, that last call was a play call from Denny Crum on the bench.
Inside Rozier with another block. This one they're going to call goaltending.
And that's one thing Coach Crum is excellent at is when they need a basket, he has great calls from the bench to see Donzel Rush.
That's block number 1. That was a good one.
And that ball was on its way down there. It was a good call, goaltending.
Clifford Rozier staking Louisville to a big lead inside on Walters. Double reversed him and got the basket.
Unstoppable. It looks like he's turned it up a notch. There's nobody on the floor that can stop Clifford Rozier right now.
20 points for Rozier. He and Salters going at it inside, and there's a foul outside. Or a call outside. It'll be out of bounds.
as Tick Rogers enters the game, and DeJuan Wheat with three fouls will sit down. 11:35 to go. We were tied this half at 30 and 32 each, and Louisville now leads at 45 to 38. Side off the mark for a three. Out of bounds, it'll go over to Louisville.
You know, Chucky Atkins is what makes the difference in the tempo of the game. I don't believe that Louisville has been able to pressure USF like they'd like to because of the great point guard play of Chucky Atkins.
Tech Rogers at the point guard position with DeJuan Wheat out. Going side to Osborne along the line. Osborne moving along the baseline. Offensive foul on Jason Osborne. Two fouls on Osborne. Louisville's got to be somewhat cautious in the foul department now with Osborne with two, Morton three, Rozier two, and Wheat three.
USF doing a great job of keeping position, doing a little acting when there's a bump. But they're a little shorter and giving up some size, but they're very quick and using their quickness defensively.
And the battle of the boards has been fairly even throughout. This is Polk with it. Robert Polk, a senior, 21. Inside, Jesse Walters knocked away. And he may have been hit in the face. Wide open to Kaiser. Rozier almost had it picked off. Jason Osborne will give it a rack outside.
Great ball movement.
Rozier coming over the back. John Clarkerty called it on him.
Bad decision on Rozier's part. You got to know when to pull back when you're out of position, especially when you're a little bit in foul trouble.
He claims he was being pushed, but that's foul number three on Rozier. And remember, Matt Simons, his relief as a muscle pull from the first half. He's had an ice pack on that on the sideline as Osborne is out. But Kaiser is in. Tick Rogers, Miner, Morton, and Rozier. Louisville 45 to 38.
USF's problem is scoring. They really need a basket here.
We come down to about 10 minutes to go. That's a Tick Rogers steal.
Bad play by Salters. He had Rozier. He should have taken him because Rozier's in a little bit of foul trouble.
Turnover by Louisville. They threw it away, and Polk almost has it taken away. It's on the floor.
Look at that hustle by Tick Rogers and Miner and Morton.
Rogers diving into the South Florida bench in an attempt to get the ball and save it. Well, they are diving for loose balls all over the court. A lot of hustle by Louisville on defense.
There's Polk trying to go one-on-one in the open floor and take advantage of the court. Gets tied up. Great hustle after the basketball.
12 turnovers for South Florida, 11 turnovers by Louisville. Polk outside, hits the iron, and Rozier grabs the rebound, and this one will be out of bounds.
That's what the number 7 team in the country should not do, throw the ball away, not pull away in situations like this.
Benny Crum obviously signaling from the bench to slow it down, take your time. 45-38.
He's got Rozier. Good call by Pascal because Rozier had to back off because of his fouls, and it looks like USF is going to attack him inside with Salters.
He's got three fouls and 20 points, Rozier. Tick Rogers for three, in and out. Kaiser has the rebound, and he scores. And that is the first basket from the Louisville bench. Brian Kaiser.
It's nice to see Kaiser in here in a tough situation because the kid's got tools.
Sophomore out of Estill County. 40 to 47 to 40 Louisville. 8:51 on the clock. Inside 15 seconds on the shot clock. Seconds. They threw it away, trying to go inside.
Tick Rogers again to Miner.
Miner fouled.
Tick Rogers on the loose ball still again. And that's why the breakaway rule that they have now is an awful rule. Now you can't grab them with two hands and just give them the fouls. We see here Tick still looks up the floor. Great. Now the defender has to go and kill him and act like he's going after the ball knowing he can't get it. Both players in this situation could get hurt. Just let the defender grab him and hold him so he won't fall. And give the shooter one and one or two shots, whatever you want to do. Awful rule by the NCAA. They're going to get some players hurt.
There's Miner at the free throw line, where he has been hitting only 57%, which is the only statistic in his portfolio that's not up near the top on the team.
Dave, the rule now on the breakaway, because it's dangerous, it's going to ruin a kid's career. If you grab the player now and keep him from falling, they get two shots and the ball out of bounds, I believe, on the breakaway rule. Change it, let the guy grab him so he won't get hurt, give him the foul shots.
Trying to distract Miner from behind the basket, and he did it. He missed the second chance. Atkins with it.
Watch him go in the lane and create.
Rush gets it back. Louisville 48, South Florida 48, 17 left. Hyatt, got it! 4 points, Vincent Hyatt. 6-point lead.
Smart move by Coach Plum, resting Rozier right now while they're up six in case he needs him late.
And without Matt Simons to put in, he's had to go with a very different kind of a lineup.
Exactly, but you know what he has on the floor? Miner, Morton, and Osborne, and Tick Rogers, and Kaiser, everybody can score.
The jacket has come off, and Denny Crum is going to have some words with his team. Let's look at our LDDS long-distance scoreboard brought to you by LDDS, supporting Cardinal Athletics with a Cardinal calling card. Other Metro games, Southern Miss trailing UNCC by a big bunch of points, and VCU by 8 over Virginia Tech, both in the second half. Back to action, South Florida now tries to cut into Louisville's 6-point lead. You see the shooting in the second half? Much better for South Florida, but Louisville's been red hot. Chucky Atkins can't get it to go. Follow, good.
Rush, a sophomore, he's going to be a force in the future.
Donzel Rush seems to get some confidence building. That's his first basket. It's a 4-point Louisville game.
We got Rozier and Miner coming back into the game at the next break.
Tick Rogers in the backcourt.
Look at Atkins deny Wheat the basketball.
There's a foul on South Florida. And they were going for the steal against Kaiser. And the South Florida player is down and hurt. I think that's number 33, Jackson. He was diving for the ball and holding his right shoulder and obviously in pain.
We hope he's not hurt too badly.
Hit the floor. Jackson, number 33, with head coach Bobby Pascal in the sweater out on the floor and along with the team trainer.
We hope that he's not hurt too badly.
6'7 senior. And he appears to be in pain. Next telecast will be on Saturday. This Saturday, as Louisville takes on.
Surprises me because Louisville, I thought, would have a board advantage coming into this basketball game.
Well, the advantage is 4 points, 48-44, just over 7 minutes to go. Louisville beat this team 80-56 in January at Freedom Hall.
USF in the 2-3 zone again, and you know, it helped them in the first half, so they've gone back to it here. Hoping to get some long-range shots and some misses and then get some fast breaks off the long rebounds.
7 seconds on the shot clock, 5. DeJuan Wheat against Chucky Atkins. Shoots, it's no good, and the foul is going to be on Chucky Atkins. That's three on Atkins.
What a great play by DeJuan Wheat. I mean, Chucky played about as good a defense as you could play, and Wheat instinctively jumps a little bit toward the basket because he had a little position on Chucky, who was a little bit on the side of him and not in perfect position. And Chucky actually tried to avoid him. Wheat played in middle school for a great coach, a middle school coach in Louisville, Lafayette Cowden at All Saints Academy.
Good job, Tony.
All right.
We're at the foul line, and it's going to be DeJuan Wheat. the best free throw shooter Louisville has, an 81% free throw shooter, 9 points tonight. Make it 10 and make it 49-44 Louisville. And the three-point shooting we could add for DeJuan Wheat, 44%, right at the top of the Metro Conference.
It certainly is, and you know, the kid has such great poise for a freshman. He has excellent skills. He's a clutch player. He's a total package.
A freshman guards at U of L, Wheat right now ranks number one, averaging 14.4. Well, Bradford Smith was at 12.7 the game. Daryl Griffith is a freshman, 12.8.
Yeah, and you know what allows Wheat to score more on this team is the fact that they have such great ball handlers and passers at the other positions. I think especially Miner and Jason Osborne. He, you know, a lot of times the point guard ends up with the ball all the time, but Wheat doesn't have to have it once they get in the offensive court.
Morton gets it to go on the follow, and he's got congratulatory moves in there from Rozier and Osborne.
He's so quick out of the lane on the free throw, but you know what? He was lucky because he waved off or pushed off with his weak hand on that, and that could have gone against Dwayne Morton. Gets in the lane on the rebound. Bad block out, but see his left hand. Not a great angle there, but his left hand, he used his left hand in there.
Morton 2 for 2 from the line. 3 for 3, 52-44, lengthens out to an 8-point Louisville lead, our biggest in the second half. The game has been tied this half twice. And free throws could be very decisive down the stretch.
I think they call Osborne inside post defense. As he gets stronger, he's going to even get better.
That's three fouls on Osborne. Morton has three. Rozier and Wheat have three each.
If I had to look at a weakness in Louisville's game, I think when Rozier goes out, they really lose a lot of power inside. I'm not sure they have a very good power game without Rozier inside.
Well, with 6.5 minutes to go, Louisville is in the bonus. But foul trouble with all those Louisville players with three. You would think South Florida would try to capitalize on that, and that is number 4 on DeJuan Wheat.
And that was a freshman mistake. He is human. He shows he's a freshman sometime. Don't bump out 25 feet away from the basket when you have three fouls on you.
Tech Rogers will come in, and that'll put DeJuan Wheat on the Louisville bench at 6:14 to go. And Louisville leading 52-44. Fourth foul on Wheat.
And Coach Crum has to take him out. You say, well, there's only 6 minutes to go. He can play 6 minutes without fouling. But he'll need him in the last 2 or 3 minutes if the game is even or tight. He's his best free throw shooter, his best basketball handler, one of his best passers. So he has to take him out now, so we'll have him in the last 2 or 3 minutes.
And he goes out with 10 points. Rozier with 20 is Louisville's top scorer and the top scorer in this game. Hyatt hits him, and it's 52-46, Louisville. The time remaining, coming close to the 6-minute mark.
Trapped in the backcourt.
Got away with it to Morton.
Great job by Tick finding the open man out of a trap.
Great pass to Rozier.
From the wizard, Osborne. He creates so many scoring opportunities for his teammates.
Louisville's lead back to 8. Rush can't believe he's open, and he missed it.
That's the second open layup he's missed tonight. I'm not sure what he's thinking about going up, but
he's got a lot of ability, but somebody's got Donzel a little psyched out. Chucky Atkins with it outside against Tick Rogers. 5.5 minutes to go. .518 on the clock, 10 on the shot clock. They're really working that shot clock down. Good defense by Louisville. Finally, they get it off to Rush. And a whistle, and it'll go to Louisville.
Credit Louisville's defense. Great defense. for the entire 35 seconds.
Traveling call, and Louisville gets it back with 5:03 to go. We're even in turnovers. Each team has committed 13.
Great. We call that an air pass, a touch pass from Osborne. He catches it in the air and passes it in the air. And that's almost impossible to defend that when you're in the zone.
Substitute, back in, Jarvis Jackson. Going out, Gonzel Rush, the sophomore out of Miami, got 2 points.
It's good to see Jarvis back. I'm glad he's not hurt.
That shoulder, he went down and grimacing in pain just a couple of minutes ago. Shot clock is at 24.
Oh!
Miner was there for the dunk, and he rimmed out.
Rimmed out, but it was fun to watch. Look, we got Alvin Sims in the game. I'm sorry. No, that's Tick Rogers. I thought I saw Sims for a minute. Tick Rogers and Rozier blocked that. That's what you call a double block.
Rozier was the guy that got the block. He's over 45 blocks now for the year. He's had a couple tonight. Four block shots of the six for Louisville have been by Clifford Rozier. So four block shots. I'm sure he's got about 10 or 12 rebounds, and we know he's got 22 points.
And that means USF had gotten it inside. Good shots. Rozier blocks them. What can you do?
Hope Chucky Atkins can hit something outside. Coming down to the four-minute mark. The shot clock under five. Partially blocked, and
Rozier was lucky. He was on the ball and could have been called for a foul. He's got to learn to stay back when you're in foul trouble.
Louisville leads at 54-46.
What great hustle by Tick. Followed his shot, out-hustled everybody to the basketball.
DeJuan Wheat is off the bench and coming over to the scorer's table. So with 3.5 minutes to go, DeJuan Wheat will shortly be back into the game. Osborne has it blocked.
And then, with his quick hands and long arms, gets the steal. Or at least knocks it loose.
Shot clock still at 26.
This is a time where Louisville looks like they want to work the clock. They're up by 8 points. They're working the clock, running off time.
The official has stopped the play and gone over to the official scorer. It must be that the shot clock was not reset. I noticed that when they went back to play. The shot clock was at about 29 or so seconds.
Okay. Well, at this stage, USF is going to need to be taking some three-pointers. I would expect to see Jarvis Jackson and Chucky Atkins, who are their better perimeter shooters, start looking. We might see Robert Polk off the bench, who might be their best three-point shooter at this time.
We got a break in the action here. 3:14 to go in a game. Louisville is up by 8, 54 to 4. And the player of the game, really. It involves Clifford Rozier, Tony Branch.
Pretty. The whole series was pretty, starting with Osborne pass, no-look pass.
Other end of the court, he has also been there to make the big plays.
Jerome Robinson probably couldn't see the basket once Rozier took off.
Officially four blocks in the game for Rozier, and that is a look at our Miller plays. We'll put an S on that, of the game. Denny Crum conferencing with DeJuan Wheat. 3 minutes and 14 seconds to go at the Sun Dome. 54-46, the shooting percentages. Louisville below what the average of 51% for the year. South Florida also under their normal shooting percentage average.
We'll see Louisville work the clock and try to get a good shot, probably go inside. Alley-oop, here it comes. They covered it well.
Miner from the free throw spot.
His elevation on that shot was just awesome.
56-46, Louisville with 10-point lead. That's at least three dunks that South Florida has blown tonight.
Rozier, that's called the Rozier factor.
Salter's got that basket, 56-48. They were tied at 30, again at 32, and since then Louisville has run out to the lead and held on to it. 10, the biggest. backwards.
No look pass to the corner. What a great pass.
Al Minor got the foul over the back, slapping at the ball. That's two on Minor and stops everything with 2:24 on the clock.
If you're a defender, you don't know where Jason Osborne is going to pass the ball. He has the knack for knowing exactly where all of his teammates are on the floor at the same time. And that creates open shots. Normally, Morton would knock that down from the corner open.
56-48 Louisville. 2 minutes and 24 seconds to go at the Sun Dome. Robinson, number 31, is at the line where he's hit one out of two. Make that two out of three. He hit one for one in the first half. And has been the leading scorer. 12 points, six rebounds for Bobby Pascal's team.
What I'm looking for Pascal to do, if he needs to, he's going to foul Rozier and make Rozier beat him from the line with the free throws down the stretch.
7-point game, and Robinson could cut it to six. 2:24, that's the time left. One thing is for sure, Tony, with 2:24 to go, Louisville's going to end up well below their season average of 85 points a game.
That won't bother them as long as they get that W.
Against the press, Quaid playing with four fouls.
You really have to be able to execute offensively here because you want to work the clock, and now you have to change your aggressiveness, your tempo. That throws some teams off offensively.
Inside 2 minutes, 7 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Rozier scoring.
Jesse Salters just is giving up too much weight, about 25 pounds and about 3 inches.
24 for Rozier. Shot, no good. Rebound, Salters. They give it to Louisville, so somebody stepped on the line, I believe, down on the baseline. Inbounds, and Osborne just lofts it over the press. A minute 34 in this game. 58-50 Louisville.
USF has got to start fouling. They've got to start pressing and fouling. They're letting too much time waste.
Rozier makes a move to the basket and scores, and there is a foul. That's 8 field goals in the second half for Rozier. This Pepsi preview reminds you that there are a few tickets to individual games for U of L. 852-5151, the number to call for that ticket information. Rozier at the line. Missed that second one. Outside Atkins. Minor. Here's Osborne. Minute 6 to go. And Osborne is fouled. Probably on Salters, 23. A 1-1.
Louisville just handles the ball so well. They can attack you from everywhere. Weapons everywhere. It's going to be difficult for USF, but they need to come down with three-pointers, quick fouls, three-pointers. Osborne inside.
We don't have Osborne with any points in now. So a little over 10 points.
Louisville's got to run the clock, make their free throws. USF, they need three-pointers, and then they have to make quick fouls, come down and try to shoot three-pointers.
Well, it's 61-50. It's 59 seconds to go. It's a big mountain to climb. That was a great pass to Summers. He wasn't ready for it. Polk rifled it in there.
USF, they've got to get a steal or foul on inbounds. They don't have time enough to wait for one player to get it like Rozier to foul him.
Osborne, a big collision, and Minor goes down. And that was a hard collision with Jesse Salters and Greg Minor.
Actually, I thought that was a foul on Salters because you have to give a player one step when he's looking back for a pass. Player with the ball, you don't have to give him one step. You see, Miner's looking back for the pass. He doesn't see the defense. Salters.
Osborne has it, 44 seconds to go.
Great cut by Miner last time. Give and go from the wing.
Well, they foul Wheat.
Chucky Atkins does, and that'll stop it at 33 seconds, and Louisville's lead is now 63-50.
Whedon Atkins, and then you look at Donzel Rush, Bozak Smith, Brian Kaiser. A lot of young, good players in the Metro. A lot of young, good players.
This is Wheat that goes to the free throw line. One for two. Now two out of three. 64-50. This thing was tied at 30 and 32. Louisville led by three at halftime. And only in the last 10 minutes of this half did Louisville start to pull away. Alvin Sims. 12 points for DeJuan Wheat. Alvin Sims, number three.